Dr. Madhu Mehta, Chairman Emeritus of Baroda Education Council. Our chairperson, Dr. Chaitanya Bhoj, Focus Committee. Mr. Vikas Chawla, Secretary of Baroda Education Council. All our committee members of Baroda Education Council. Today's faculty, Dr. Urjit Thakur, Dr. Rajiv Shah, who are present here. All the invitees and members of Baroda Education Council. A presentation from Global Hospital team on showcasing the innovation which is in place at that hospital. The majority of details will be covered by Dr. Bhoj. So I'll not give you the details on the theme of this today's presentation. But on behalf of Baroda Innovation Council, I take this opportunity to welcome you all to this presentation. I'm sure the end of the presentation, you all will be great to learn on a new innovation which is in place in our city, and we will take a pride for this innovation. We also take this opportunity to invite you to be part of Baroda Innovation Council, which are doing meaningful programs in a various capacity, in a various sector, education, policies, as well as at large in the society. Not taking much of our time because it's already been late, I would request that the program be proceed further. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jagdish Bhai. One question before we start the session. How many of you are coming for the first time in this Vadodara Innovation Council program? Please raise your hands. Tamaramati kitla eva se ke pindi for Vadodara Innovation Council na program ha? So I think it's more than 70 to 80%. Okay. Gujarati is okay, English is okay? Gujarati English is mixed, okay? Okay. I'll take another 2 to 3 minutes to discuss, to talk about Vadodara Innovation Council, because I see મોટા ભાગના લોકો જે છે એ પહેલી વખત આવી રહ્યા છે. વડોદરા ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ શરૂ થઈ અને 2 વર્ષ પૂરા થયા છે. વિચ વોઝ ધ આઈડિયા વોઝ પ્લાન્ટેડ બાય ડોક્ટર શ્યામ પિત્રોડા, એડવાઇઝર ટુ ધ પ્રાઇમ મિનિસ્ટર એન્ડ ધ હેડ ઓફ ધ નેશનલ ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ. ઇટ ઇઝ અ સ્પેશિયલ ઇનિશિયેટિવ બાય ધ પ્રાઇમ મિનિસ્ટર ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા એન્ડ ધીસ ડેકેડ હેઝ બીન ડિક્લેર્ડ એઝ અ ડેકેડ ઓફ ઇનોવેશન. ઇનિશિયલી 2 યર્સ બેક હી requested Dr. Madhubhai Mehta, his friend, and Pareshbhai Parekh, and then we formed a team, and we are proud to say that this journey has really given us a lot of encouragement. We are proud to say, આપણે બધાને ગર્વ થાય એવી વાત છે કે આપણે વડોદરાને આખા દેશના ઇનોવેશન મેપ પર ચોટીના સ્થાને મૂકેલું છે. વડોદરા ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ ઇઝ ધી ફર્સ્ટ એન્ડ ધ ઓનલી નેશનલ ઓનલી સિટી બેઝ ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા એઝ ઓફ નાઉ. In fact, we are proud to say this, thanks to Baroda, thanks to people, and thanks to the DMDIC. Second thing is that now we are considered as a role model, and we have been asked to replicate this particular city-based innovation council module across India. We have prepared a manual. Very briefly I'll say what we have done. Very quickly. Of course, it is not possible for one man or a two man. Actually, we have a good team. This last 2 years, every month on second Sunday, we are organizing the seminars and talks on innovations, and it is a regular program. Our another activity was, we started one initiative, and the chairperson was Jagdish Bhai Shukla. Under the leadership of him, Preeti Ben, and there were many people, and we had a team of around 10 to 12 volunteers. And we went to around 32 to 35 schools, out of which there are 15 schools of municipal corporation. And we covered 10,000 students of 5th, 6th and 7th standard. And our initiative was to conduct a session in the schools for 1.5 hours for 5th, 6th and 7th standard, how to be curious, questioning and innovative. This model attracted the National Innovation Council. In turn, they invited Baroda Innovation Council people to present this particular presentation at National Innovation Council. And now they have asked us to again replicate this model across India. Our another initiative was Tod-Phod Jod Center. And we had a 12-week pilot program. Mr. K.G. Shah conducted and designed the entire workshop. and in turn we got a good response. And then in February, Community Science Center, we trained around 54 teachers and school principals. And there were people from Kutch, Baroda, Surat, Bharuj. And now our aim is to set up a Code 4 Door Center in every school. We in fact conducted one more training program in ITI where 18 ITI principals and then faculty members were present. And again we are trying to set up a Code 4 Door Center in ITI zone. That was second initiative. Third initiative, as you know that in BCCI exhibition in 2013, recently in February, thanks to iCreate Madhubai and Parubhan Kaptari, we requested them, and for the first time, you know, there was an entire pavilion, pavilion number 16, which was dedicated to innovation. And we selected the teams from college and school and from ITIs, and we displayed their innovation free of cost. It is happening for the first time. And we thank BCCI, President Ravi Sabhawala and Dilesh Bhai Shukla for that. We showcased innovation from schools and colleges free of cost. Again, there were two initiatives from Vadodara Innovation Council. Thanks to Paruben again and Madhubai, and we initiated two programs. And more than 70 teams took part across Gujarat. There were two initiatives. One is I Explore and another is I Innovate. And the students from schools, colleges, they visited the stores and then talked about what was the history, how can we innovate further. And another was about the competition innovations, and we had given the prize. So there are multiple programs we are happening, and now I would like to say that our next theme, our next vision and mission, as far as Vadodara Innovation Council is concerned, is that we want to make Vadodara as the innovative city of India. Please. We want to make Vadodara as the innovative city of India, and I want and I request all of you to please join us in that mission. We are soon going to launch many programs. It will be on radio, it will be on TV. We have a team working immediately after this program. We have an executive council meeting working on that. And you will see a lot of results on that side. But it will not happen from one person only. We need a team for that. I'm not taking now time because we now go to the first session about happiness ICU. But after that program, we will have 10 minutes interaction session wherein if you want to ask any questions, we are open for that. I request again that all of you can join us. And let us be proud. Let us make our Vadodara proud. We already put Vadodara on the top of the innovation map, but then we still want to do something extra. Right? Now, the design of today's program is that we will have around 50 minutes session from this happiness ICU, and then later on 10 minutes session or open session for how can we take Vadodara Innovation Council further and we can fulfill our mission. I now invite Dr. Chaitanya Bhuj, the Vice President of Vadodara Innovation Council, for the next session, please. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. On this beautiful Sunday morning, in spite of availability of so many other programs in the city today, you all are here with us and in a large number. So I am very thankful to all of you. ઘણા બધા ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન માં એવું લાગતું હોય કે કાશ આપણે આવું કંઈક કરી શકતા હોય તો કેવું, પણ અમારી સાથે વિકાસ છે એટલે કોઈ ચિંતાનો વિષય નથી. વી હેવ ઓલ ધ ડિગ્નિટરીઝ ઇન ધી ઓડિયન્સ એન્ડ વેલકમ ટુ ઓલ ઓફ યુ. ટુડેઝ પ્રોગ્રામ એઝ વિકાસભાઈ રાઇટલી ટોલ્ડ, વી આર પ્લાનિંગ ટુ પ્રોજેક્ટ વડોદરા ઇનોવેશન સિટી એન્ડ અંડર દેટ વી હેવ વેરી મેની થિંગ. વી હેવ ધ ઇનોવેટર્સ આઇસોલેટેડ એન્ડ લોકેટેડ એન્ડ found from Baroda city, from the schools, from the colleges, from the practicing persons and consultants, etc. And we will be demonstrating and showcasing it to you and reach your home as Vadodara Innovative City on the radio, on air, will come to your home. So various other things will be done. But today's program, as you have seen, there is no gain without pain. A person coming to ICU is in pain, either pain from the traumatic experience or a fracture or the disease or even the treatment, the injections, the IV fluids, the operations, and also being on ventilator or dialysis or various other procedures. And therefore, there is no pain, there is no gain. So we had our share of pain today. Let us have our gain today. The program today is that we will have, when a patient goes to ICU, with pain and wants to come out after relief of pain, the process in between is somewhat troubled because what happens, the relatives want to be close to the context, and the discussion will be done by Dr. Budgir, who is our speaker today. Dr. by Abhidhai, Dr. Vikas Bhai said that we change the speaker, but I would say that we keep the same speaker, and speaker Dr. Udgir will talk today about what happens and how do we improve the happiness in ICU, and that is the main theme today. I thought that with such an important program of an ICU, where I had written in my invite also that we ICU, so I see you. When I see you in ICU and Udgir is looking after, there is a difference, and what is the difference is what we will talk about. So such an important event which is happening for the first time in Vadodara and Gujarat and Maharashtra, I thought that we must have a person who will chair this session, and he should be an international teacher, or he should be a doctor, because we are talking of ICU. Or I thought that if he wanted a very good speech to be given, that it should be an artist or a actor or a educationist or somebody who is with a school or somebody who is an orator or somebody who is knowing Gujarati and English very well. પછી આ બધું બોલતા બોલતા મને એમ થયું કે આપણે બહાર દુનિયામાં કંઈ જવાની જરૂર નથી. વી હેવ એમોંગ્સ અસ આવો એક જી કે જે રાજીવ છે, ડૉક્ટર રાજીવ શાહ, ઓર્થોપેડિક સર્જન. આઈ ઇન્વાઇટ હિમ એઝ ધી ચેરમેન ફોર ધ ટુડેઝ ફંક્શન, એન્ડ વી વિલ સે દેટ ડૉક્ટર રાજીવ શાહ, ફ્રેન્ડ્સ, યુ ઓલ નો, ઇઝ ધી મેનેજિંગ ડિરેક્ટર ઓફ ગ્લોબલ હોસ્પિટલ, એન્ડ હી ઇઝ હિમસેલ્ફ એન ઓર્થોપેડિક સર્જન. But we are in a school setup, and he has started a back school, the school for the back problems. And he has left by starting a foot clinic. Miles need travel karva mate foot and ankle clinic, one of the only. And he is the one person who has had a gold medal in Gujarati. He got the best student in MS orthopedic surgery, but gold medal in Gujarati. He has been a coordinator for the Yuva Vani on All India Radio, and he comes as an actor in drama on radio and TV. So friends, not only in ICU, but when I cannot see you, at that level also, he is very active, and therefore, we are very lucky that we have with us Dr. Rajiv Shah, and I would ask him to tell us about, see, nothing ever starts. Things are always created twice, first time in the mind and then in reality. So how did the idea get conceived, and then comes the delivery, and the delivery will be by Udgir, but the conception and how it was nurtured, and out from where in Maharashtra and Gujarat the ICUs were fairly fertile, they were producing very good results, but the hiccups that were there, how could they be streamlined, what was the need, and why did we think about it, is what I want our today's chairman, Dr. Rajiv Shah, to inform us. So I invite Dr. Rajiv Shah.
तुमसे सदियों की वफा था ना था,
दिस इज बेटर, माइक पर बोल मु, मैंने कॉलर माइक पर बोल मु, ए भाई कॉलर जॉब नहीं आ मैं बना रही
तुमसे सदियों की वफाओं का एक नाता था, तुमसे मिलने की लकीरें आज मेरे हाथों में. गुड मॉर्निंग. At the outset, let me thank from my bottom of my heart Vadodara Innovation Council, Dr. Chaitanya Bhai, Dr. Madhu Bhai, Vidish Bhai, Vikas Bhai, and Paresh Bhai, and the team to invite us to share this dais in front of this techno-savvy population. Before I really call upon Dr. Udgir, I would take you back to the gestation of this thought process. As a doctor and as a managing doctor, managing director of a chain hospital, I have always found that there is a lack of feeling of trust and transparency amongst the population with respect to medical population, medical fraternity, medical profession. And our constant endeavor was to remove the
this bridge, this barrier.
See, it so happened that 10:30 p.m. I just finished one of my surgical case and I was just leaving out of Global Baroda Hospital. And at the watchman's gate, watchman's cabin, somebody was just fighting. भाई मुझे अंदर जवाब दे रहा था. वॉचमैन वॉज टेलिंग सर सिक्योरिटी वाला जी सर न जाए साढ़े दस बजे कोई पेशेंट के अंदर ना जाए. देखो हूँ मोरबी से आयो छू मैंने जवाब देव पड़े हम जवाब देव पड़े तो सर मड़वा समय चार थी पांच वो है हॉस्पिटल दरवाजा दस वगे बंद थी गया. तो आई जस्ट केम इन टू दी पिक्चर आई से अंकल शू प्रॉब्लम है तो सर हूँ मोरबी से निकलो छू મારા પેશન્ટને મારો ભત્રીજો આઈસીયુમાં છે અને હું પણ પરદેશથી આવીને સીધો જ મોરબી જઈ અને અહીંયા આવી રહ્યો છું. તો અંકલ પણ આઈસીયુમાં મળવાનો સમય સાંજે 4 થી 6 નો છે. સર હું એટલા બધા ટાઈમ સ્પેન્ડથી નીકળ્યો હતો કે હું 2 કલાક વહેલો પહોંચવાનો પણ રસ્તામાં ગુજરાત ગવર્મેન્ટની બસ પકડી તો શું કરું. અને હિઝ પોઈન્ટ વોઝ ઓલસો વેલિડ. એ તો એક કામ કરીએ અંકલ કાલે હું તમને સવારે વહેલા 9 વાગે અમારા ઇન્ટેન્સિવિસ્ટ જોડે મેળવી દઈશ પેશન્ટનું મોડ પર બતાવી દઈશ. એન્ડ હી આસ્ક મી અ સ્ટેલી ક્વેશ્ચન ડૉક્ટર આર યુ શ્યોર કે કાલ સવાર સુધી જીવશે એન્ડ ઇફ હી ડાઈઝ ટુમોરો મોર્નિંગ આઈ વિલ બ્લેમ યુ બીકોઝ આઈ કેમ રાઇટ ફ્રોમ આફ્રિકા ટુ મીટ હિમ ટુ સી હિઝ ફેસ યુ આર નોટ અલાઉઇંગ મી. ધીસ વોઝ વન એક્ઝામ્પલ. હું એક સર્જરી કરી રહ્યો હતો. સર્જરીમાં વારેઘડીએ ફોન આવતા હતા. એઝ પર માય હેબિટ આઈ વોઝ નોટ આસ્કિંગ માય અસિસ્ટન્ટ ટુ પિક અપ ધ ફોન. અને સર્જરી પૂરી કર્યા પછી મેં ફોન લીધો. ફોન અમારા આઈસીયુમાં થયો. વેરી સિમ્પલ થિંગ આઈસીયુમાં જેવું કરે સર આ પેશન્ટને ડાયાલિસિસ પર મૂકવાનું છે. આઈ વોઝ મેડ વિથ ધેમ. 2 કલાકથી આ પેશન્ટને એક્યુટ ડાયાલિસિસ જરૂર. તમે મારા ફોનની સર પણ ડરાવજો છો મારા ડિસિઝન મૂકી દેવો છો. આજે they said, but relatives wants to see your face. Relatives want your consent because you are the doctor in whom they have trust. તમારું મોડું તમે એકવાર કહી દો ને એ લોકો કે બધા પેશન્ટ મરી જશો પણ રાજીવ એમને કહેશે કે હા ડાયાલિસિસની જરૂર છે ભલે ઇટ્સ નોટ માય સબ્જેક્ટ ત્યારે અમે એને ડાયાલિસિસ પર મૂકવાનું. There are so many such examples. Few days back, somebody called me up, sir, અમારો પેશન્ટ આઈસીયુમાં મરી ગયો છે અને અમારા પેશન્ટને ખાલી સપોર્ટ પર મૂકી રાખ્યું છે. અમને મરી ગયું છે એટલે અંદર નથી જવા દેતા. તમે કહો અને અંદર જવા દે. આઈ ટોક ટુ ધ ઇન્ટેન્સિવ. હી સેડ લુક દે હેવ ધીસ ફીલિંગ વોન્ટ યુ અલાઉ ધેમ લેટ ધેમ કમ ઇન લેટ વન ઓફ ધ પર્સન કમ ઇન એન્ડ સી કે ભાઈ પેશન્ટના વાઇટલ્સ બરાબર ચાલે પેશન્ટ જીવે છે. દે ડીડ ઇટ. પેશન્ટના રિલેટિવનો ફરી ફોન સાહેબ અમે જોયું અમને શું સમજ પડે અમારા ફેમિલી ડોક્ટર જુએ ને કે તો જ અમે માનીએ. સો ઓલ ધીસ પ્રોબ્લેમ બોબલિંગ આઉટ ઇઝ લીડિંગ ટુ અ ક્વેશ્ચન ઓન ટુ ધી હેલ્થ કેર ડિલિવરી સિસ્ટમ. એટ વન એન્ડ વી વોન્ટિંગ એબ્સોલ્યુટ એબ્સોલ્યુટ ઇન્ફેક્શન ફ્રી એન્વાયરમેન્ટ એબ્સોલ્યુટ પ્રાઇવસી ઓફ ધી પેશન્ટ. એટ ધી અધર એન્ડ ધીસ આર ધ પ્રોબ્લેમ. હાઉ કુડ વી મેચ હાઉ કુડ વી બ્રીચ ધીસ ગેપ. એન્ડ One day Dr. Urgit came to me and said, sir, what is expected out of me? I said, Dr. Urgit, this is a very, very challenging thing we expect from you. And I said, in many ways, we have gaps to bridge. And in a fraction of a second, this young, energetic gentleman came up with, sir, the only answer to this is technology. I could not palate that. How could technology bridge this gap? Yes, he has done it, he has done it, he has done it so emphatically that before I was of the strong belief, before this existence of this life, I was of the strong belief, telling everybody, Na avyu aankhma aansu, na avyu aankhma aansu, vyathaye laaj rakhi chhe, dawani gayi asar jare, duhaye laaj rakhi chhe. But now I say, ટેકનોલોજી લાજ રાખી છે. સો લેડીઝ એન્ડ જેન્ટલમેન, here with I present Dr. Urgit Thakur, Department of Health. Please, Dr. Urgit.
Scenario in healthcare is so big that now पहला फक्त दर्दियों गोली એટલે કે ટેબ્લેટ વાપરતા હતા હવે ડોક્ટરો ટેબ્લેટ વાપરતા થયા છે અને હવે એમને ખબર પડશે કે વોટ ઇઝ ઇટ ટુ બી લાઈક અ પેશન્ટ સો આઈ રિયલી બિલીવ ધેટ એવરી ડોક્ટર વન્સ વન અવર ઓર થ્રી અવર્સ ઓર સિક્સ અવર્સ ઇન અ યર શુડ ગેટ એડમિટેડ ટુ આઈસીયુ અધર્સ આઈસીયુ સો ધે વિલ નો વોટ ઇટ ઇઝ ટુ બી લાઈક અ પેશન્ટ એન્ડ હેવ અ ટેબ્લેટ બટ ધ બેટર એડવાન્ટેજ ઓફ ટેબ્લેટ હ્યુમન્સ ક્રિએટ ટેકનોલોજીસ ધ હ્યુમન્સ આર ધ સેક્સ ઓર્ગન્સ ઓફ ટેકનોલોજી We produce technology. Now, production availability does not do anything unless we are aware and we use it. So, let us talk and see and showcase the use of technology in ICU. Dr. Urgit.
Thanks everybody and very good morning to all of you for coming to this auditorium on such a beautiful day. Very good morning all of you. Lights be switched off so that I can on my projector. Okay, so here we begin with the presentation. The topic of the presentation is Happiness ICU, Technology for Medicine, and myself Dr. Urgit in front of you. Small disclaimer. Greetings from my institution, that is Global Baroda Hospital. Photograph of ICU. This is how we work. This is a base model of an ICU. We can see ventilator here. This is a ventilator. If you can see the arrow, this is a multi-parameter monitor. This is a light source. This is suction machine. All these things are infusion pump. This is IV pump. Can you say me what is missing in this photograph? What is missing in this photograph? Yes, very right. Patient is missing. So if we take a photograph of a working ICU, it looks like this. So many gadgets, so many persons working, fighting for their patient's life. And these two persons sitting here, they do monitor everything. If we compare this, we can compare this with this thing. This is a war room where they plan the strategy of the war. These two persons are looking after the same. Or we can compare it with this photograph. This is the cockpit of a fighter plane or a passenger plane where the life of all the passengers are dependent on these two pilots. Salient features of an ICU, it's complicated inside. Taking the critical in is a very balancing act and we deal with life. And it's very precious, the most precious things above money and above everything. Multiple devices makes it complicated and infection control is a constant problem in ICUs. 70% of people die in ICU due to some or other infection. 70% of people die due to infection, which we call as sepsis, septic shock, multi-organ dysfunction. And if we can prevent, we can infection, we can save so many lives, so many lives. Again, communication and coordination is critical. Na samrayo, bhuli garo, rahi garo, that is not absolutely not allowed in ICU. What is relatives' perspective? When a patient is admitted, they are already stressed because someone is very critical and admitted in ICU. Our family member is very serious, anything can happen. Another thing, ICU means I am not allowed inside. All over the world, ICU means I am not allowed inside. And third thing is I am confused what's going on because they are not medical person. Inside, the things which we are doing is complicated. We cannot explain it 100% to the relatives. Now the question comes, I want to make it very clear because why the entry is restricted in ICUs? Patient admitted inside are very sick and can pick up infection very easily. Normal person moving around in the community will not be infected by the bacteria, but the patient in ICU, because of his illness, his capacity to fight the infection is compromised and that's why they can develop an infection. Privacy of the patient is responsibility of the treating team because in ICU all the patients have complete bed rest. So privacy of the patient is also very important and many more reasons for the same. What relative want? The relative's perspective is I want to be with my patient when he is ill. He is ill, he needs me. I have spent 50 years of my life with the same person and when I need him, you are not allowing me. Valid. My brother wants to see my dad but he is at USA. He is admitted just for observation. For two things we admit the patient in ICU. One thing is for is critically ill, he requires ventilator, dialysis and so on, which is not possible in ward. Another thing is he has undergone a major surgery or suffered some illness in which we anticipate that he may develop some life-threatening complication, and we observe it, and if it occurs, we deal with it. So he is just admitted for observation. Kind and talk to him, valid. High amount of money spent doesn't always translate into recovery. 80% of money spent in ICU are spent on the patient whose chances of recovery is only 20%. 80% of money spent because chances of recovery is only 20%. We want to increase that chances of recovery, so we go on spend. We go on spending the money after that patient. Each doctor is explaining different things to me. It's also valid. If you say a 5-year-old that pick five sentences about an elephant, he will speak. After 1 hour, you ask the same child, that again you speak it. So there is a difference of one or two words. Relatives are absolutely not ability. One super specialist talks about his system, goes away. Another specialist comes and talks about the another system. Relatives ask the previous question. And it's not wrong, but there is a communication understanding error. It's practically possible and we cannot eliminate it. I want to have an opinion of expert from Mumbai, but I cannot afford the cost. It's not feasible for my specialist from all the way from Mumbai, from Morbi, or maybe from any other place. The relatives are actually right. The discrepancy is high cost spent in the ICU with ill health of the relative will lead to loss of transparency. Loss of transparency will lead to loss of trust. Why? Why is the problem? The doctors are wrong? No, they want to prevent infection, they want to save lives. The relatives are wrong? No, they are absolutely right. If at some point of time, I am not a doctor and I am relative of a patient who is admitted to ICU, what I would think the same thing. I would also be with my patient, I would like to talk, take a second opinion when someone is telling that even after spending so much amount of rupees, your relative is not well, then I want to have a second opinion. It's very natural. Relatives are right, doctor is right. Where is the problem? Problem is with the system. System created for the benefit of both doesn't allow the communication. It is a problem of the system. That's why the confusion and all things matter. The problem of the system, if we categorize, is loss of transparency, or the Shitanavaka, with loss of trust, or Vishwasniyata. Because there is no transparency, that's why there is no trust. What we want is trust with transparency, Vishwasati Paradarshita. What we want is trust with transparency. But we have restrictions. Quality of care requires restriction of handling. That's why distrust is likely. Quality of care requires multiple specialists to manage the patient. And that's why communication error is very likely. Any solution? I was thinking the same thing. Are we perfect? What improves us? Humans are the same for 1,000 years. I work with two hands. I work. Since so many years, we are working with two hands. Apne apne haath mein kitlu bodhu vapariye chhe. Chata ma bena chaar nathi thata hai nathi thata. Hazar varas ki emma emma chhe. Human body has two eyes, one mouth, one heart, one kidney, two lungs, two kidneys and two lungs. Technology changes fast. What changed around us is technology, and it changes the world around you, making world a better place to live. The need of human race are fulfilled by the technology. So if we want to change something rapidly, you want a revolution, you want to change something, then human body has its limitations. We have to take advantage of the technology. It was very clear that what we were not able to do previously, now we can do with the help of technology. It gives us infinite possibilities, as seen on TV commercial when I was watching a TV. And when we connect, can we connect our patient to that? Can we connect our patient to technology? Let us try. This was the TV commercial, the flagship phone of Samsung at the current scenario. Live in world of infinite possibilities, and the tagline is life from patients. And if we have patient's life, can my patient be benefited by the same? I have with technology. So what we want is technology for medicine. This is the synergism between the human being and the technology. Medicine on the wings of technology. Harry Potter again alone cannot fly, but with this device he can fly and he can go whenever he wants. The medicine is now on the wings of technology. We have searched all possible sources that each company has done it, how they have done it, we want to do the same. There was no practical way already created. We have searched Google everywhere. Then we need to create trust. Person is creating the role. Then the question comes about the innovation. So for innovation, there is an innovation change model as well as the components of innovation shown there. There are four questions which we need to ask ourselves before to proceed for any innovation. Why, how, when, and where? Four simple questions. Why? Why you want this innovation? For what purpose it is? Bigger the why, more are the efforts. In this case, the why was biggest because we are dealing with human life and human lives are the most precious thing on the world elevator. How? Is it possible practically if I think something abstract which is not possible right now and maybe possible after 10 years? When? I have to innovate it right now maybe, but practically I have to do it after 10 years, not now, because the community will not accept it. And where? The community, if it accepts, then only it is practically applicable, otherwise it is not practically applicable. So then the question comes of the main. The innovation was practically possible, so we came forward again. And now the name. The name should relate to the purpose. Our purpose, very carefully friends, our purpose was to infuse trust with transparency in the system, to give health with happiness to the community. हमें सिस्टम में पारदर्शिता और विश्वास मूकीने कम्युनिटी ने એટલે કે લોકો ને હેલ્થ વિથ હેપીનેસ એટલે ખુશીની સાથે હેલ્થ આપવા માંગીએ એન્ડ હેન્સ ધ નેમ વોટ વી હેવ ટેકન અપ વિથ ઇઝ હેપીનેસ આઈસીયુ ઇફ યુ સર્ચ ઓન ગૂગલ હેપીનેસ આઈસીયુ ધેર ઇઝ ઓનલી વન રેકોર્ડ ઓફ ઇટ નો વન હેઝ કેપ્ટ ધીસ ટુ વર્ડ હેપીનેસ ઇન આઈસીયુ હેપીનેસ આઈસીયુ ટુ વર્ડ્સ ટુગેધર નો રેકોર્ડ ઇવન ઓન ગૂગલ Happiness ICU is India's first tablet-powered ICU, tested on all possible sources. Happiness ICU is patient-friendly ICU. Happiness ICU gives trustless transparency for health with happiness. Happiness ICU gives prayer 8 a.m. 8 p.m. with relative, patient, doctor, and nursing staff all together. Happiness ICU plays soft music in non-emergency hours. Our highlightment of our theme. And this word, tablet for happiness, a tablet, a medicine. For happiness, a khushini body. And at the same way, the tablet. The tablet means a tablet computer as well as a tablet. Now we'll see how we work in a system called Happiness ICU. There are three components at present working for the Happiness ICU. The component one is remote access of the vital data of the patient. All ICU monitors are connected to central monitoring system. Central monitor runs on a software, that is Windows. In a computer program, it's a computer program after all. We can change it. The humans, we cannot change. But technology, definitely, we can change. Ek manas ne tikku bhave se. Kuhene ka oke, aaj ki tare tikku nahi, aaj ki tare gadiu bhave se, oke bhave. He will say, but he will like, miss you only. But in technology, if you change something, we program it. Ke hove thi me too. Me too, pati ke bhave. That's why it changes fast. Specialized application can be installed in the system to make monitor accessible from anywhere through the application. Multiple applications are available in the market. Most user-friendly, freely available, and cross-platform applications are used. This is a photograph of the system. And this is our ICU, Global Garda Hospital ICU, live in front of you. All the patients' data is available here. It's connected to a 3G dongle. Here it is, connected to a 3G dongle, and from internet, after authorization, which I have already done, we can see all the patients there. It's live. If you are present there, you can see the same thing about all the patients. Suppose if I want to take blood pressure of this patient, I have to open the window. All the parameters are highlighted. If I want to take blood pressure, I have to just click on blood pressure window and I have to press start. The previous reading will vanish off, will be replaced by a question mark because the machine is taking the blood pressure. The pick-up will inflate on ICU bed number 5, Global Garda Hospital, and give us a new fresh BP reading from anywhere in the world. On any device, on your tablet, mobile phone or computer. Thanks a lot. If I want to see the electrocardiogram of the patient, I like to click on multi-lead ECG. ECG appears. If I want to take again, I have to click update here. If I want to take print out of the same, I have to click print for my reference. When I reach to the hospital, I want to see this data. So I will print it out. The print will come out from the printer which is installed in the hospital. I can see the trends. Last 48 hours, what happened with my patients that I can see here in a graphical format as well as tabular format. I am seeing since the at this time maybe 10:55, but what happened 2 hours there, I can track 8:30 p.m. this was the vital data of the patient. And I can save it for my future use. Now this is a new BP reading. The figure was the same, but it's the new BP reading. And all these things are live. If you see at GPH ICU, the live things are happening because time is very crucial. Suppose patient is serious. Suppose this 120 heart rate or this 67 heart rate is very different from this 68 heart rate. You can see both numbers are same, but you can see the lines. The lines are different. The electrocardiographic tracing are different. What you are using right now is a simple phone call that heart rate is this much. Then you rely upon the medical officer, but now I can see the patient from anywhere. Same thing, the same thing as Global Meridian ICU, our sister hospital. One of the hospitals in our group, the Global Meridian ICU, all the patients are here. Like, if I want to see something about this patient, I have to open the patient window, and at the same time I can have this is the BP reading, I can start state, I can adjust the alarm limits also. Sorry. I can adjust this alarm. If it goes above 120 or it goes below 50, it will give a beep that I can adjust according to the patient from a distance place, from my mobile phone or my tablet computer or from the from anywhere in the world. Like, so okay. This is the central monitoring, and I think we have demonstrated it live. This was about it. On tablet and mobile phone, I cannot project tablet and mobile phone to the projector. That's why we have a video of it. This is the live video. This is my mobile phone demonstrating all the vital data of the patient. I can operate it, scroll it around. So this projector is connected to a computer. I cannot detach and connect to my mobile phone. So now this is my tablet. The tablet computer, my personal tablet. Now I can see all the data on it. This is how remote access system works. There are 4 or 5 monitors controlled by a central monitoring system which works on LAN, that is local area network. We have given an authorization and a special application so that it can transmit the data through the internet to any other device which is authorized. Mobile phone, tablet or computer. Now we can view vital data as we have already seen live. Can see trends, alarms, take blood pressure, ECG, can set alarms through the central system. Benefits, qualified doctors can see the patient's data from remote location, can recognize abnormalities at earliest and can overcome it by appropriate treatment at the earliest. And double check on vital data. This data, heart rate, pulse, BP are the most basic things and it's the most important thing for us because what we want is to maintain the basic function of the body in ICU. It's the most important thing. We can prevent a disaster by knowing the risk. The idea to execution, it was my idea but formulated into a physical thing by Mr. Prabhupada. Here it is. Please share IT. You are going to be hospital. No one is going away. We are watching you, with you, right through, for your patients. After setting up all the devices, this is the patient's plate, if you can recognize, and all these machines of ICU, the doctor is going away. We are not going away, with you, right through, connected to the technology. Pitfall. Only electrical data is not always useful. Sometimes actual situation may be quite different than what we see as numbers and lines. Answer, what is the answer? Again, through the technology. Now the components to Happiness ICU. Video conferencing facilities. Video conferencing requires following things. Basic requirement like the human body's requirement is some basic functions of the organ. The technology of video conferencing requires following things. A video camera to see yourself, microphone to talk with, speaker to listen to it, screen to see the other person's face, the operating system to operate it all, and a software and internet to connect to such units. Where is available? Let us search. Everything is available in a standard mobile phone, tablet, laptop or computer. Why not a tablet for each and every patient? Tablet for happiness. This is a photograph of all our tablets
altogether.
Can we have the session? We just switch over the projector that they are connected live to the.
Please don't.
Okay, fine. Okay. This is GBH ICU live. Okay, I can see the monitor. I can see the pulse rate is 63 with little ST depressions. Saturation is 99. Respiratory rate is 20. BP is normal. Can we give some verbal command to the patient so that we can see what you are the hemiparesis component, if it is improving or it is the same? Because I have seen him previously. I want to see what is the improvement. Hemiparesis is a type of paralysis. So now the neurophysician across the globe can see their patients whenever they want. They can compare their own data. They need not depend on anyone else for the same. The competency of each and every doctor is different. Even my competency with other doctors is different. I did not rely on anybody. I can call the ICU from my mobile phone or my tablet or on a computer. I only need is a good internet connection. Now a bedside tablet. We have given tablets to each patient. Among the infusion pumps, ventilator, and messy report files and X-rays, CT scan. Now we have a wonder powerful communicator, important dictator, a magnificent visionary with 5 megapixel camera, a friend and a guide, a reliable, absolutely user-friendly, and ready with us to battle life and death with a fresh charge of it. We'll see now the relative's perspective. The same way, the way we have seen the patient, the relatives can also see the patient with definitely after authorization. They can see the patients whenever they want. They can be assured that expert team of doctors available easily through Happiness ICU. They can now do no harm by seeing their patient. In special cases, relative can see the patient and possibly talk to them through the tablet to their distant relatives. At any time, they can see their patient and they can now see the costly medications being administered. A single medication costing 30,000, 40,000 rupees to increase the amount of transparency into the system. They will be administered to the patients in front of the relative's eye, and it's absolutely required. This is the video of how we do it. We have seen the other part of the system, how doctors can see it. But what we do, this is a video of the same. Let's have it. This is a patient scenario with the nursing chart and tablet, and patient is little irritable, not following exactly verbal command. The tablet rings.
The pulse rate is 99.
You can see the doctor in the tablet inside. Inside there is a doctor's face. These are the ventilatory settings which I can see or any doctor can see from distant place and can change it. The ventilator. This is how we can see, this is how we operate the system from the other end. Do we have another ICU online? Please switch over the projector so that we can make it live. Is he conscious? I just want to see his GC status. Can we give some verbal command of pain or something?
Yeah, he will follow the verbal command, but he is a little bit drowsy.
It's okay. Okay, it's very nice, Dr. Maya. Do we have his MRI or X-ray or something? Do we have the plates or can we see them? Hello? So not only the patient, we can see the reports, we can see the lab reports, we can see, now this is the MRI. Please keep it steady. Okay. Can we see the treatment sheet? We can see the detailed MRI and we can take the snapshot of the same and we can save it also from our computer. But at present we are running short of time, so we'll just keep it. Okay. Closer please. Okay. I can get injection data card, pentosid and observe pairing clopidogrel.
Thank you very much, Dr. Thanks.
So this is how we do it. This is the component diagram of the same. Please switch over the projector. Give you few seconds. Okay. This is component 2, video conferencing facilities, like diagram. I don't have any photograph of doctor holding a tablet for the patient because we are doing it for the first time. But you can consider that board as tablet. Patient in bed, doctor with tablet computer, with internet access and video conferencing application. Through authorization, they can talk to the treating team like the way we have done. They can talk to the relatives. Two doctors communicating, the third doctor can present at the same time to the video conferencing facility. We can see, talk to the patients, reports, vitals, inspection part of the examination. There are four parts in medical examination: inspection, palpation, percussion, and auscultation. The inspection part we can perform actually by seeing the patient. The percussion, palpation, and auscultation, three parts the medical officer can perform on behalf of us, and we can monitor what he is doing is right or not. And the expert opinion and second opinion is possible. Suppose I am an expert doctor talking to the patient like this. I can examine patient for 15-20 minutes and I can come to some that whatever treatment is going on is right or not. Extension of services. Rural India is waiting for the specialist. to arise while no one is interested to serve towns and villages due to valid and obvious reasons. This technology will fill up the gap between the rural and urban treatment standards by extending super speciality consultation services to rural India, the actual India. Global Bharuch Hospital, now equipped with happiness ICU. The remote center health. We will see a short video, not the whole of it maybe, but a short video, how the patient is managed through a remote center. The call was done from the our command center, that is Global Baroda Hospital, to Global Meridian Hospital when they have received a new patient. Not that clear, but you can see inside the television. We can see the vital data, and we will switch over to video conferencing at the same time, in real time. We can see the patient line and the data line. See, when a new patient arrives to the hospital and he is critically ill, as a doctor, I should not waste the time to go to that hospital and see that 5 minutes are the most crucial minutes for the patient. I wanted to see the patient from my home only, and this is possible now through the technology. Expert opinion is possible. Technology will bring the experts around the world to our doorstep. They can see the patient, give their opinion, can discuss with relatives about the line of treatment and the prognosis. I have developed a part, or we have developed a part of this application, number of applications which are done by the tablet. A part of it is developed. Now sky is the limit. We can do many more things, like application is available for glucose monitoring of the patient. Now medical officer can directly insert old sugar level, new sugar level, infusion rate of insulin, and the application will give the new rate of infusion of insulin. We can see multiple drugs, interactions, side effects of multiple drugs, all connected to internet through the tablet for the patients. We can see the slides and plates of echocardiography, we can see endoscopic videos, and we can see whatever we want through the connected to the net. Even we can email the patient. We have Global Bharuch ICU online, so we'll just talk to them very quickly. Global Bharuch Hospital?
Hello, Global Bharuch? Hello? Hello? This was a patient? Hello, this
will
be the patient.
They are connected, but they are not able to listen to it because Global is basically a rural setup and we are depending on internet connection. It will take some time, we'll reconnect it. Meanwhile, we'll see the third component of the system. Communication gap in ICU, it heals. In era of super speciality, critically ill patient is being managed by more number of doctors. And communication among the doctor is absolutely essential. It is not possible to convey everything to everyone. Suppose 8 doctors are seeing after looking after one patient: nephrologist, neurologist, cardiologist, physician, intensivist, hematologist. It's very practically possible in ICU. Communication among the treating team is very important, and we cannot a decision of pulmonologist to everyone. It is not practically possible. And even if it is done at the level of medical officer, and it can create human error. Suppose I tell the sentence to the first person and I listen it from the last person, definitely it will be different. Some words are added, some words are missing, the total meaning changes. If I inform everybody going on informing, it will be 80 to 90 calls up upper from the ICU. That is not possible. We are there to manage the patient. We are not there as a communicator, as a telephone operator. What is the answer? Again, the technology. Our note-taking system. When I pass my MD or when I am working right now, I write orders on pen and paper. My sir was doing the same thing, and he told me that his sir was doing the same thing. In last 50 years, we have switched over from postcard to mobile phones, calculators to computers, ink pen to roller pen, maybe. But medical documents is pen and paper, still it is pen and paper. The science of medical system has evolved. We will get the CT scan done. CT scan machines are so advanced that we will get the CT scan done within 6 seconds, the whole body CT scan, 3D, within 6 seconds. Then what? Then we take the films of that, then we print it. Then Hello? Is this Global Bharoch Hospital?
By us, but they have tried to contact to keep not realizing we are in a meeting.
So, believe it or not, it is true that our medical system is note-taking system is like a cycle, and the medical science is like an elephant. Discharge summary agenda. The most junior person usually does the. The most junior person will do the paperwork. If it is important, then most senior person should do it. Our practice that we write everything on paper, then at the end, at the time of discharge, we type it and make a discharge summary, and then we give it to a patient because it looks good. But why can't we take notes from beginning, from the day one of admission, in digital format so that we can send it anywhere? Type in tablet, synchronize with reading team, discuss, decide and execute. There is no handwriting problem also for in reading chapters handwriting. This is a diagram of note-taking application. Sex notes, photographs, not only writing notes, we can take photographs of the patient of clinical signs. We can take audio recording of the patient, of speech if it is abnormal. We can key in whatever way we want to. And Dr. A, B and C, the treating team, can see the patient, read the data and can modify it from their mobile phone, tablet or computer. The referral doctor who has referred the doctor from center from the periphery, like Godhra, the patient is referred to Global Godhra Hospital. The doctor sitting in Godhra is not a part of treating team, but still he can see what's going on behalf of patient's treatment. Second opinion also can be possible by changing the medical notes. Now you can write, speak, listen and see your notes, not just reading. X-ray CT scan can be uploaded, audio notes can be uploaded, doctors can write notes from the mobile phones. And they can see all patients' record from the same. Catch, Evernote, and all these applications can be used. We'll just very, very briefly we'll demonstrate note-taking application. This is what we are using. This is the name of the patient. All the notes are written here. You can see that if I want to see vital data, okay, I just have to click here. The photograph will show us the vital data. It will take some time to load. This information is synchronized with all the doctors of the treating team. We can send an invite, and these are the persons, Dr. Shaibal Zagadi, whose patient was there, myself and Global Meridian ICU. We can invite the doctors here. They can authorize it by accepting the invitation, and then they can see the notes, change it, or see the data or whatever they want. Now the happiness ICU. The component 1 is remote access of vital data, component 2 is video conferencing, component 3 is medical notes management system, synchronized all together. In a nutshell, if we want to see to a normal public what we have done, now doctor can, in the orange balloon, the doctor can see live vital data, if required can examine the patient, discuss with other doctors, can read treatment sheet, see radiological and lab data, and finally write his opinion, changing treatment, which can be seen by all treating doctors from his tablet, computer, or mobile phone, anywhere in the world. Future perspective is an era of tablet revolution. Paperless hospitals can be planned, application of patient management can be planned, and I, as I already said, sky is the limit. Thank you all. Happiness ICU, now demonstrate it. Thank you very much for my team of my doctors, what we are together managing the ICU, for my nursing staff, and thanks for Vadodara University Council for such a wonderful opportunity. Everything happened in the morning was an accident. First, the speaker we have tested it, it was working fine, and suddenly there was a smell of something burning, and the Bose audio system is the best audio system in the world, I can say the Bose. But the sound of Bose, but it failed, it happens, happens in the technology, but then we overcome it, then GB problem again overcome. Thanks very much, to the VIC for the opportunity and wonderful coordination.
This year, a student's punch and a pandit punch. So we all from Arizona, he was there as a volunteer in the conference, and I tell you that I so far used to use the word mind. Is this is for everybody in mind, and mind in my mind was medicos, interns, nurses and doctors, but now I have changed the word today, and a new word have been downloaded just now in presence of Udgi, and he is responsible for it, that I have now not mind but reminder, because we can't do this without an engineer. And we can't do it without a doctor, without a relative, and without a patient. And therefore, there is a relative and a patient, then we have mind, and then at the end, it all is supported by an engineer, ER. So, R-E, M-I-N-D, ER. And unless together everyone achieves more. So, unless we work as a team, you want to go a short distance, go alone. But you want to go long and far and wide all over the global world, then you have to work in a team, and I am so happy that you have done. Mitro, apne janiye chhe ke prani ne jiva mate joye chhe fakt charo, manas ne vadharama joye chhe vicharo. Jeni pase nathi sara vicharo, fakt e j chhe vicharo. To apne apna vicharo ma je sudharo karyo ane hard disk update kari, te mate Udgit, Dr. Rajiv Shah, ane bija badhano, ane aap sarvano, hu ghano ghano abhari chhu. Thank you very much. I hand over to further Vikas.
See, we have a short of time, so we will probably take one or two questions as far as happiness ICU is concerned. I think Dr. Udgit and Dr. Bhuj can answer that. And we will switch over to the next session, and I will then invite Dr. Madhubai Mehta on the stage. But before that, one or two questions very briefly, please. Yeah.
6 o'clock surgery puri kari ne, I conference attend karva. In between interval ma hi aaya hai che, and the next surgery pachi kaam karvani che Rajiv bhai ne.
Yeah.
When you are connected with the internet and using the Skype and that different software, then what about the security? If anybody can hijack your system and gain the data?
Very nice question. Actually, I wanted to discuss this. And we have taken care of the negative part of the technology first. First, the security of the system and misuse of the tablet, both the things. What we have done is, there is an authorization, if you can see in the flow chart, authorization at every place. The doctor connected to the patient should log in with their username and password. Have you done any electronic transaction of your money to the bank, or you have purchased anything to the credit card? We are doing it. The system is secure. The same way we are managing the patient. Your money are important for us, our patients are important. We are using the standard applications for that, and they have a very good security backup, and we log in with our username, ID and password. Varucha ICU has logged in with their username and password, and what call at what time for which duration was attended by the ICU is recorded as a log, like in your mobile phone. Similar way at each and every place, the authorization is absolutely required.
The patient security part is taken care of, because the daughter is looking after the father, or the father wants to see the daughter, and both have authorized, and the hospital has authorized, and we are on an internal network. Cyber security from the cyber hacking and crime point of view is a different issue. He also, being an adult medicine specialist, has not realized
But when there is a 18-year or younger child, and if video clip conference was going on, then there will be too many issues because we cannot show a child. But that is currently not a situation because we are trying to help. And people understand that instead of coming from Kenya, a surgery and angioplasty was being done on my brother's friend, and my brother wanted to see that angioplasty. People who were outside were waiting for the results to come. The brother saw actually the angioplasty, what was going on the screen, live in Kenya. So this is done with their consent, and people understand. And actually, US president na data ma badan ras hai. Maru vajan 45 che ke 55 ke 85 ma khub jani jaye, so I think I am visible, and my data is known to others, is not going to harm too much.
We will take one last question now, because then we will switch over to 10 minutes another session. Yeah, Makona sir.
ટેબ્લેટ ઉપર સામેના એટલે ઉપર બધું જોઈ શકે પણ એ દર્દીના રિલેટિવ માટે લગભગ નથી મળશે કારણ કે બધું ટેકનિકલ છે દર્દીને બે રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ છે એક તો દર્દી અરે રિલેટિવને બે રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ એક તો દર્દીની તબિયત કેમ છે અને બીજું કે એની ટ્રીટમેન્ટ બરાબર ચાલે છે કે નહીં એ બે વસ્તુ એને જાણવાની જરૂર એ બે માંથી એકય વસ્તુ આમાંથી દર્દી રિલેટિવને દેખાતું નથી
આ ટેબ્લેટ વાળો ડોક્ટર એ પેશન્ટનો સેક્રેટરી છે સેક્રેટરી એ જેને બતાવે છે કે આ તમે મેડિકલ ઓફિસર વાત કરો છો ટેબ્લેટ પેશન્ટને આપવામાં આવે છે એને હેન્ડલ નથી કરવાની પેશન્ટને ડ્રાઈવ કરવું છે તો ડ્રાઈવર છે ગાડી છે બધું હોસ્પિટલ તરફથી આપવામાં આવ્યું છે પણ જનરલ રૂમમાં બેસીને 6 ટીવી મૂક્યા હોય અને તમે જો જોતા હો તો મારા ફાધરને શું થઈ ગયું છે એ પહેલાં બેને જોવાની શું જરૂર છે ત્યારે ટેબ્લેટમાં 1-to-1 છે એટલે ટેબ્લેટ ફૂલ્લી કોન્ફિગર્ડ છે પેશન્ટ ખાલી એને વાત જ કરવાની છે બધું જ પેશન્ટની આગળ આ ટેબ્લેટ જે છે એ ડોક્ટર આગળ છે એ પેશન્ટના બેડ ઉપર લગાડેલ છે અને ડોક્ટરના હાથમાં જે છે એ ડોક્ટર જે એક્સેસ કરે છે એ એની દીકરી કે દીકરો કે ગમે તે એ બહારથી એક્સેસ કરી શકે છે એના માટેની વ્યવસ્થા વ્યૂઇંગ એરિયા બધું જ થયેલું છે એવો પણ પ્રોબ્લેમ છે કે પ્રાઇવસી લોકો કેથેટરાઇઝ કરે છે તો તમે કઈ રીતે બતાવી શકો તો એ વખતે પડદાની બહાર ઉદ્ગીત હેઝ સીન ટુ ઇટ કે ધ વિડિયો કેમેરા gets connected on sky is outside the curtain so that whenever there is a privacy requirement catheterization chale che kapda badalvama aave che sponge karvama aave che to a camera on thase pan e dekhase khali padto what is happening parde ke piche will not be seen so relatives have to not bring anything relatives have to understand nothing they will just say ke mare amne malu che ate aa left aa tablet par emne batai devama aavche am I right
yes sir and relatives there is a special room for the relatives in which અત્યારે થોડી મિનિટો આપણે જોયું અને રિપોર્ટ જોયો એવું નહીં રિલેટિવ પેશન્ટને જોઈ શકે એની સાથે વાત કરી શકે શું ખાધું પૂછી શકે ભાવ્યું કે નહીં પૂછી શકે આજે આપણે વાત કરી એટલી મતલબ આપણી પાસે એટલો ટાઈમ નથી એટલે આપણે એ રીતે બતાવ્યું આપણે જે વાત કરી એ મારી જગ્યાએ તમે પણ વાત કરો તો તમે એઝ અ રિલેટિવ પેશન્ટ સાથે વાત કરી શકશો દેટ ઇઝ રીઝન વાત દેટ તમે 100% કરી શકશો અને આ સિસ્ટમ બનાવી જ છે
અને સેકન્ડલી જે કંઈ પેરામીટર તમે ડિસ્પ્લે કરો છો એ પેરામીટરમાં કંઈ એબ્નોર્મેલિટી થાય તો રિલેટિવ તો કંઈ ટેકનિકલ નથી એને ખબર ના રિલેટિવને પેરામીટર નહીં કંઈ પેરામીટર એબ્નોર્મલ થાય તો ઇન્ડિકેશન સાથે આવે તો રિલેટિવ એને ઓબ્ઝર્વ કરી શકે
રિલેટિવ
ધ્યાન કરી શકે
ના રિલેટિવ એ નહીં કરી શકે કારણ કે ડોક્ટરનું કામ છે અને એના માટે ટ્રેન સ્ટાફ
ડોક્ટર કે ટેકનિકલ માણસ કોઈ એને જોતા નથી કોઈ પણ કારણ
ના ના એ જોઈ જ રહ્યા છે
મારો એક મારો પોતાનો પર્સનલ અનુભવ છે
આપણે પર્સનલ
એટલે ડોક્ટર ટુ ડોક્ટર નોટ
પેશન્ટ
પેશન્ટ અને ડોક્ટર
પેશન્ટ અને એનો ડોક્ટર એમનો ભાઈ ડોક્ટર છે કાર્ડિયોથોરેસિક એ યુએસએ થી જોઈ રહ્યો છે કે મકવાણા સાહેબ આને કરાઈ નાખો ઓપરેટ કોઈ વાંધો નથી
સો વી કેન ગો હે એવું એક ત્યાંથી કેરીઝોનાથી કહેવા માંગે છે કે ઉદ્ગીરભાઈને કહી દો કે એન્જિયોપ્લાસ્ટી કરાવી નાખે પણ તમને તમારો ભાઈ કે પછી તમે હા પાડવા માંગો છો અને એ મારો કાર્ડિયોલોજીસ્ટ છે છતાં હું આના ઉપર કઈ રીતે કરી શકું નિર્ણય તો તમે સીધી મોકલો પછી આવશે પછી એવું નહીં તો સગાઓને માટે આ એક પ્લેટફોર્મ ઊભું કરવામાં આવ્યું છે ત્યાં સગા અને એમના સગા દુનિયામાં ગમે ત્યાં હોય આ પેશન્ટની વસ્તુ જોઈ શકે સમજાવી શકે અને કરી શકે સો આઈ થિંક વિથ ધેટ બાય રાજીવભાઈ એન્ડ ધેન વી વિલ હેવ નો ક્વેશ્ચન્સ બટ વી વિલ ડિસ્કસ આફ્ટર ઇન ઓપન ફોરમ આઉટસાઇડ
થેન્ક યુ બહુ અંગત વાત તમને મારા 28 વર્ષના મેડિકલ પ્રોફેશનની કરો છો એકવાર અમારી પાસે પેશન્ટ હતો પેશન્ટનો સન ડૉક્ટર હતો અને એણે મને અમેરિકાથી ફોન કર્યો કે ડૉક્ટર સાહેબ ડુ યુ ફીલ કે આ પેશન્ટ જીવશે અને મેં કહ્યું કે ધેર આર હાઈ ચાન્સીસ કે આ પેશન્ટ નહીં જીવે
તો તમે શું એડવાઇસ કરો છો? મારે આવી જવું જોઈએ અમેરિકાથી? આઈ સેડ તમારે આવી જવું જોઈએ. એ આવ્યા. ફોર્ચ્યુનેટલી ફોર અસ, અનફોર્ચ્યુનેટલી ફોર હિમ, પેશન્ટ બચી ગયો. એટલે જતી વખતે એમણે મને અને ડૉક્ટર ભીખુભાઈને બેસાડીને કહ્યું કે આ તમે એક બહુ જ ક્રિમિનલ કામ કર્યું છે, કારણ કે તમે મને ત્યાંથી બોલાય, હજુ આ વ્યક્તિ મરી નથી, હજુ મારે ફરી આવવાનું થવાનું જ છે. બટ એના ગયા પછી જે પોઝિટિવ પાર્ટ ઓફ ઇટ જે અમે લીધું કે એ ડૉક્ટર લીવરના કેન્સરનો સ્પેશિયલિસ્ટ હતો, એની એપોઇન્ટમેન્ટ એક્રોસ 3 સ્ટેટ માંડ માંડ 2-2 મહિને મળે એટલો ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ માણસ હતો. એ એના માટેની રિસર્ચ કરી રહ્યો હતો. એના 4 દિવસ જો આપણે અહીંયા લાવીને એને બગાડીએ તો એના દેશના લોકોને એન્ડ ધેર બાય ટુ ધી હ્યુમન કોમ્યુનિટી એ ઘણો મોટો લોસ હતો. એટલે આ એંગલ પણ મેં ઉદગીતભાઈ જોડે ડિસ્કસ કર્યો કે કાલે ઉઠીને કોઈને અમેરિકાથી આવવું છે નથી આવવું, એના ત્યાં એના ડૉક્ટરને બેસાડીને રૂમમાં બેસે અને જોઈ શકે ને એના ડૉક્ટરને જે બિલીવ કરશે. અમારો પ્રોફેશન ટ્રસ્ટનો છે, બરાબર. હું ભલે ને ઓર્થોપેડિક સર્જન હોઉં પણ સ્કિન વીડીનું પ્રોબ્લેમ હશે તો પણ પેશન્ટ મને જ પૂછીને હું કહીશ ત્યાં જશે. એટલો થેન્ક યુ.
કાલિદાસ પછી પહેલો નંબર અમારો જ છે અને અમે મારી જ રહ્યા છીએ. એન્ડ વી નેવર એવર થિંક લાઈક ધેટ, કારણ કે અમારા પણ સગાઓ બાંધા પડશે ને એમના માટે પણ જરૂર પડશે, એટલે આપણે બધા એક બોટમાં છીએ. સો વી એન્ડ યુ નથી, આઈ સી યુ નહીં, વી ઓલ સી ટુગેધર ધીસ સોલ્યુશન એન્ડ યુ સી ફોર અસ.
વી હેવ રિસીવ 98 પેશન્ટ્સ લાસ્ટ મંથ. આઈ હેવ સીન ઓલ ઓફ ધેમ બટ નોટ અ સિંગલ ઇમરજન્સી વિઝિટ. આઈ હેવ સીન ઓલ ઓફ ધેમ એન્ડ મોડિફાઈડ ધ ટ્રીટમેન્ટ અકોર્ડિંગલી બટ નોટ અ સિંગલ ઇમરજન્સી વિઝિટ. વેનએવર ઇટ્સ રિક્વાયર્ડ આઈ હેવ રીચ્ડ, બટ વેનએવર ઇટ કેન બી મેનેજ્ડ I can manage or I can see it at time whenever it is required in crucial 5 minutes. Another thing that relative session, you can anytime visit us. There is a special configuration, special system applied for the relative in the conference room, in a counseling room, where we sit, we have sofa, we have a TV and we have all the communication system so that relatives can sit there, watch their patient for 1 hour, not just 5 minutes, chalo jori du jata ro jori du jata ro, nahi. બેસી શકે, જમતા હોય એક જણ અંદર જમાડે, બે જણ બહારથી જોઈ શકે, એમની સાથે વાત કરી શકે. અને એઝ અ ડોક્ટર આઈ વોઝ ટોકિંગ, ધેટ્સ વાય આઈ હેવ ટોક્ડ એઝ અ ડોક્ટર. યુ કેન જસ્ટ કમ હિયર એન્ડ યુ કેન જસ્ટ ટ્રાય ટોક ટુ અ રિલેટિવ, એઝ અ રિલેટિવ ટુ ધ પેશન્ટ, વિલ રિસ્પોન્ડ ટુ યુ.
ઓન બિહાફ ઓફ BIC મેમ્બર્સ એન્ડ ધ ઓડિયન્સ એન્ડ ધ પેશન્ટ્સ, આઈ થેન્ક યુ રાજીવભાઈ એન્ડ ગ્લોબસ લોન્ચ, એન્ડ વી આર very thankful on behalf of patients, relatives and other witnesses here, because we do not have time. I thank all of you. Thank you, and over to Vikas.
Let us have a big round of applause for Dr. Rajiv Udhi and Dr. Ketan Udhi. We will take another 5 to 10 minutes, because we are going to talk about 1 hour. ત્યારે જી બી વાળા સ્પષ્ટ કીધું છે કે અમે તમને 1.5 કલાક આપી દઈએ હિયરિંગ, એન્ડ ઇટ વોઝ, આઈ નો ધીસ ઇઝ અ બિગ સબ્જેક્ટ એન્ડ લોટ ઓફ ક્વેશ્ચન્સ આર ધેર. But now we switch over from happiness ICU to Vadodara Emotion Council. And I would now request Dr. Madhubhai Mehta, the Chairman Emeritus, former President of Vadodara Emotion Council, to be on the stage and say his expert comments about this particular session and how we can take this forward and how can we make Vadodara as the innovative city of India. Madhubhai.
તમને વડોદરા ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ વિશે પ્રશ્ન હોય તો કહેજો. વડોદરા ઇનોવેશન કાઉન્સિલ જે આવતા વર્ષમાં કરવાનું છે તેનું થોડું ઘણું વિકાસભાઈએ કહ્યું છે. એઝ વી જનરલી સે કી ટોકિંગ ડઝ નોટ રિયલી મેટર એઝ મચ, વી રિયલી નીડ ટુ બી એબલ ટુ પ્રોડ્યુસ રિઝલ્ટ. થોડા ઘણા અમારા અત્યાર સુધીના રિઝલ્ટ અમારી સામે છે જ, અને હોપફુલી ભવિષ્યમાં વધારે ને વધારે સારા રિઝલ્ટ આ લોકો પ્રોડ્યુસ કરતા રહેશે. We are getting notice all over the country, so hopefully things will happen. So,
I request that if you have any questions as far as how can we make Vadodara as the innovative city of India, I think we can take another 5 minutes for the session. Any questions or any suggestion from your side? One more. The names of innovators, and you know our innovators from Baroda or from Vadodara Innovation Council were showcased in a vibrant Gujarat. Same way we did it in VCCI also.
So this way we can showcase the innovations and innovators.
This is a doctor engineer forum. And the attempt was that doctors and engineers came to the API platform for Vega Guy. So, product is a Vakarwa Matena. ये बदला चेंजेस करवा पड़े ये बदला ये डॉक्टर से करवा पड़े जो इनिशिएटिव डॉक्टर की पद्धति आवे कुछ आ वस्तु ये एक्सेप्शनल आए और सोसाइटी में चेंजेस आवे तो गेटिंग डॉक्टर्स एंड इंजीनियर्स वर्किंग टुगेदर गोइंग टू बी वेरी मेजर इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन फॉर फ्यूचर एनीवे हमारे कोई सवाल है